Good morning, my dear brothers and sisters and friends. May the Lord bless you richly. We continue in the letter of John, chapter 2, verses from 9 on. Pay attention because these are very interesting verses that are going to take us to a practical living in the Lord. The one who says that he is in the Lord, but he hates his brother, is still in darkness. He who loves his brother abides in the light, and there is no cause for stumbling in being. Verse 11, but he who hates his brother is in darkness and walks in darkness and does not where he is going, because the darkness has blinded his eyes. Dear brothers and sisters, we continue to meditate in the first letter that John wrote. And the ones reading it, the ones that are following every day our devotionals, have realized that John is a man that wants to take us to a practical Christian living. I have always said in other occasions that it is important to know, we give it a lot of importance to the knowledge of the scriptures, but the objective is not to learn and to broaden our knowledge, but to take all that knowledge into practice. Because what good is it that we know a lot about the Bible if we don't live it, if we don't practice it? We're going to be hearers and not doers of the word. John, in this occasion, is talking about something that unfortunately happens in congregations and in daily living. And that is that there are people that have personal problems with other people. They have hate, resentment, bitterness, bad memories, wounds, words that have been said to us. And those things have caused a wound that for years is open. And John teaches us something that is very interesting to know, and especially to practice it. We cannot live Christian lives in victory when we have in our hearts things against other people. I have said resentment, bitterness, lack of forgiveness is not right. All of those things are interferences. All those things are negative things that are going to affect very badly our relationship with God, even with us. Bitterness, a lot of times, is the result of lack of forgiveness. It could be that they have hurt you. It could say that they have said things to you that have hurt you. I'm not saying that doesn't happen, but how are we going to deal with that? What reaction are we going to have in front of all that, mockery? My dear brothers and sisters, let's look at Christ. Our Lord Jesus Christ understands very well what is to be rejected, to be alone, to be mocked, to be lied about, because he experienced that in his own flesh. Do you remember that verse in Isaiah 53, that he was a man of suffering and familiar with pain? He was rejected, and he was broken, and he was mocked. They ended up crucifying him. Glory to God that he resurrected on the third day, but sometimes he said that he used to cast demons by Beelzebub. Sometimes they said he was crazy, etc. He knows what it is to be rejected and misunderstood, but misvalued, but he never let resentment get into his heart. On the contrary, he said his final words on the cross, "Father, forgive them because they don't know what they're doing." John, or better said, God, through the writings of John, says that if we reject our brothers, if we hate our brother, we are in darkness and we are liars. And it says that there are stumbling blocks in our lives because they come because we have had a wrong attitude. This is something to be taken very seriously. A few days ago, somebody asked, how do we prepare to have the Holy Communion? Well, the Bible says to examine ourselves, to test ourselves. So that's why it's very important that every day, in the light of the Word of God, in the presence of God, we ask Him that He will give us love, that He will give us grace, so that we can, with His help and His blessing, to forgive others, pass the page, and not be in all our lives going around and around in circles about the same wounds, about the same conversations, about the same things that have been done to him.
It
is very important that we fill our hearts with him, with the Lord, so that we can forgive
and
just being able to get all this behind us. If we don't do that, our Christian life is not going to grow and it's not going to develop. Today you have to make a decision. Forgive that one that has offended you. Forgive that that has treated you unfairly. But that with the love of God, we can forgive and we can walk our whole life in the light of Jesus, following and imitating his example, just doing and saying exactly what he said and he did. Because there is not other way. It is not optional. It's not like one we forgive and other people we don't. It's not like we hate it and then we love others. No, it is not like that. It is something that is a commandment. It's a biblical commandment and it's imperative. And the Bible says, the one who says that love God and he despises his brother is a liar. We have read that he is in darkness. There is no light. There is no light of God in him. If there is something in your heart against somebody or something, then just meditate on that and pray that the Lord will show you whom you have to go and forgive or just ask forgiveness. And then you're going to see a complete freedom. And you're going to see how God is going to break something inside of you that is going to allow you to enjoy. It's going to allow you to be in peace, to be happy and joyfully and victoriously, so that the Lord has that prepared for you. I know, and I repeat, that you may be right, humanly talking, to not forgive, to not talk to somebody, but may never happen in your heart that is against somebody, that you they can say whatever they want to. They're free to do so. They can do, they can say whatever, but you have to rise up to that situation. It is the only way that you are not going to live in bitterness, in depression, in a very big sadness and constant sadness. That wound that they have done to you will heal. And when you remember that, you can say, in this area, in a very difficult time of my life, the Lord gave me his grace and victory so that I can be above all that. And now I can tell as a triumph, as something that gives honor and glory to the Lord. So dear brethren, let's pray. And we are going to practice today forgiveness. If we today only not know about forgiveness, but we apply the forgiveness, if it is necessary, because there is nothing worse than living under sadness and bitterness of something that has been done to us and that we have never been able to overcome. Maybe our prayers have not been answered. Maybe we haven't mature enough. Because we haven't forgiven from our heart that person that has hurt you. So if somebody comes into your mind or the face of somebody that has hurt you, that have made you cry and suffer, say, Lord, in the name of Jesus, I forgive him. And I ask you, Lord, to help me just overcome this wound so that in the name of Jesus I can demonstrate that with the love and with the grace of God I can overcome anything in life. Father in heaven, thank you for your word. Thank you because you have demonstrated to us your love, the patience, the mercy, and the grace that we can have in difficult times in life. Today, we make a decision to forgive and to overcome anything that has been done to us in the past and look at you and follow you, only you, because we know that from you we're going to receive grace and strength to be able to overcome what the enemy is trying to use to stop our maturity. We surrender to you in the name of Jesus. Amen and amen. My dear brothers and sisters, may the Lord bless you. I say greetings to you. We're going to have a victorious day today and a blessed day because the Lord is with us. And if he's with us, who can be against us? So, like I say all the time, to the majority of you, enjoy your relationship of your Christian life, because what we have is something so wonderful and marvelous that it has to be contagious. Let's forgive. Let's just pass the page and walk from glory to glory, from victory to victory, and from blessing to blessing. May the Lord bless you. May you have a wonderful day in the name of Jesus.